Now, let's start with the introduction of charging capacity of a conductor. In this section, we are going to discuss when a conductor is charged. There exists a maximum limit up to which the conductor can be charged, which is called charging capacity of the conductor. About an isolated conductor, we can say, here we'll write, for an isolated conductor, once some charge is given to it, its surface charge density, this can be given as sigma is inversely proportional to the local radius of curvature, which we already studied. And this is because of the whole metal has to be equipotential. And at every interior point, electric field has to be zero. Now say we are given with a metal body, which is of a random shape. Then in this conducting body, when some charge is given, we know that on the sharp edges, charge density is more. And at relatively larger radius of curvature, the charge density is less. And in this way, charge is distributed on the whole body. And due to the charge as being a metal body, we have studied that electric field exists in the direction perpendicular to the metal body because this metal surface is an equipotential surface. And here we can see in the region where charge density is more, the electric field strength in the outside region of the sharp edges of the conductor, electric field will also be more. Because just outside a metal surface, electric field is written as sigma by epsilon naught. So, in this situation, on the flat surfaces, the magnitude of electric field is relatively less. And in just vicinity of just outside the conductor, in the vicinity of sharp edges, the magnitude of electric field is more. And if such a body is placed in a dielectric medium, we know that due to this electric field, all the dipoles of medium will get aligned in the direction of electric field like this, as positive zones of the dipole will experience a force away from the charged body and negatives are attracted toward it. So, all dipoles in the surrounding will get aligned in such a fashion. Now, in this situation, if we just have a look on a specific dipole, we can see that a dipole positive charge will experience a force away from it and a negative charge experience a force due to this charge of body toward it. Now, as the body charge increases, say if the body is charged with the charge Q and if Q increases, we can say the force on each dipole, which is stretching the two poles away from each other, will also increase. And we can say there exists a maximum value of this charge at which this force will increase up to an extent that it will break the dipole. Now, as soon as the dipole will break, the charges in the medium will become free to move and the medium will also act as a conducting media and the charge of the conductor will leak it out. And we can see as the electric field in the surrounding of conductor is maximum just outside the sharp edges, so the dielectric breakdown takes place first in the vicinity of sharp edges. The phenomenon of dielectric breakdown is basically the breaking of dipole due to the electric field of the charged conductor in the medium. So, here we can also write it like just outside the conductor, if electric field exceeds the breakdown strength of dipoles of medium. Here we can define breakdown strength as the maximum electric field up to which the dipoles can persist and beyond which the dipoles will break due to the stretching force. We can say just outside the conductor, if electric field exceeds the breakdown strength of dipoles of medium, charge of conductor will leak out in surrounding medium. So here we can say, in a given medium, when a metal body is placed, there exists a maximum limit of charge up to which the metal body can be charged. Beyond which, if we supply some charge, its electric field will produce dielectric breakdown in the medium, or dipoles of medium will break and the charge will start leaking out. And it happens mainly at the sharp edges of the conductor. So, this is the maximum limit up to which the body can be charged. This is called charging capacity of the conductor. So, here we can write that for every conductor in a medium, there exists a maximum capacity up to which the body can be charged, and it depends on, there are two main factors on which this maximum capacity of charging will depend. The very first thing is the shape of conductor, because we have discussed that in conductors having sharp edges, charging capacity will be less, because from the sharp edges easily the charges will leak out. And the other factor will be the breakdown strength of surrounding medium. If the surrounding medium dipoles are strong, the breakdown strength of the surrounding medium dipoles will be high, and it can sustain up to a high value of electric field, so body can be charged up to a more or maximum value of charge, which will be higher compared to a medium in which the dipole dielectric strength is less. So these are the two main factors on which the maximum capacity of charging depends.